music, we love their style.
They are the best group in the world.
Our fans are so important to us. It's really cool when they listen to your music and they know it, and they get excited. The second, you just hear the screams, it's like, and you just get that rush.
But I guess you start to get used to it just because you get like people saying how they look up to you all the time. So you're like, whoa. And you kind of really relate to them and you want to like be there for them because you know how it feels to look up to somebody.
Fans are definitely, definitely, definitely important. And artists have to realize that if it weren't for fans, you would not be here.
I think that they have a lot going on. I think they're a positive black force.
I'm a survivor. I'm not gonna give up. I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna work harder.
Try to breathe without you. I'm in heaven. But I couldn't see without you. Perfect vision.
Well, I think when it comes to messages that Destiny's Child send, it's definitely be empowered, be yourself. So that gives us a very special connection.
Destiny's Child has expanded my horizon of what I want to do and what you can accomplish. And it doesn't matter what age you are, you know, you can do whatever you want to do. And just look at me, you know, and I have a rap magazine and I'm 17 years old.
Destiny's Child messages are so positive. Destiny's Child fans realize that through following your dreams, you can have any and everything you want. And that is something that Destiny's Child fans have in common.
Watching Destiny's Child go through all what they went through and making their dreams come true makes us work harder every day and not give up.
When we're extra, extra tired, we go 150% to try to make everybody feel special. There's no way you can't be happy and feel blessed when you hear all of those screams. It's like amazing.
Walk with me, Lord.
God is the reason for everything, definitely for our success. And people wonder how we stay so grounded and how we stay together and we stay strong. That's our trick.
We sing for God above anybody. And we let them know that if they don't know God, that you should get to know Him.
Every day we do a gospel song, and that might introduce them to God. Some of the people that don't go to church, that do come to concerts, are exposed to God.
Amen. Amen.
My name is Lauren Zell. I'm 31, and I've been a Destiny's Child fan since day one.
What's going on, Instructor Aquino?
I work at Chicago Transit Authority. I am a training coordinator, and I love my job. My job requires me to develop training materials for our bus and rail operations throughout the entire city of Chicago.
Cannot start any day without some Destiny's Child to get your day going.
Till I see my sister.
Larzell has a shrine in his office of Destiny's Child.
See, I'm trying to give you that 360-degree angle of Destiny's Child so everywhere you look, you can see Destiny's Child. I try to at least put up a different Destiny's Child screensaver at least once a week.
Oh, I think Larzell's life without Destiny's Child would be an empty shell, a vacuum.
We're dealing with three women who not only sing, but them independent women can sing. Do you hear me?
I believe the one he always talks about is Michelle?
Yeah,
Michelle. That's the one he's always talking about. He's always pointing at Michelle.
Michelle Tanitra Williams, to be exact.
He knows her name, her address, her shoe size.
I am Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Around my family and at work, I'm like Mr. Conservative, Mr. Nice. But around my friends, I am like just a clown. I am a fool.
DC3, vile!
Okay, I know everybody got the little camouflage look going on right now, and that's cool and all. But does everybody have them some DC3 icon pants? Bam! Look at that. Check it out. Each of these is a song of Destiny's Child. That's Bills, Bills, Bills. You know what that is? That's Bootylicious. That's a bug. Ah! Boo! Bugaboo. You happy? You sad? What is that? That's emotions. Everybody should have these. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
I really like when I see the people dressed in army fatigue and they like get rhinestones and they make Destiny's Child clothes, or when they stay up all night making big posters. It always feels good when you're on the stage and you see, I love you, Kelly. I love you, Michelle. We love you, Beyonce. We love you, Destiny's Child. We are survivors. Those posters, it's like, yeah.
DC3 taught me that wearing original clothes represents you. And if you represent yourself, you'll never, ever, ever be put down. Destiny's Child fans realize that through following your dreams, you can have any and everything you want. And they also realize that Michelle is just beautiful, from the hair on the top of her head to the bottom of her feet. When I was a kid, I remember wanting to dance. I had a friend who, she belonged to a dance academy. And I remember just seeing her dance, I was like, man, oh, I wish I could get up there and dance. As an African-American teenager, male, growing up on the South Side, you had to be hard, you had to be masculine, you had to be into sports. If you were a male and you danced, especially with tights on, please, dudes from the hood, you just didn't do that. When I got rid of my fears of what people would say or think about me, I decided to dance. A lot of that had to do with when Destiny's Child went through a lot of controversy and they still didn't stop. Nobody gave Beyonce, Michelle, and Kelly their stardom, their success on a silver platter. Those three independent women worked hard for it.
Thank you.
They say that men are dogs, that men are bad, that men are no good, and we want to show a different revelation for men all over this country.
The Men's Dance Ministry is a group dedicated to dancing for the love of God and to give back everything that God has given through us from our blessings from the gift of dance. It's a form of self-expression. And I'm finding out with anything, if you don't express yourself, you're not complete, you're not whole. Usually when we perform, it's usually for religious-based events, but we have done picnics, family reunions, and other things.
Before each show, Destiny's Child, of course, we gather with our band and our dancers, and we say a prayer. At the end of the prayer, we put our hands in the middle of a circle, and we say, Lord, thank you for letting us do what we love.
Lord, thank you for letting us do what we love. Break it
on down. When we finish, we do this like little dance where we go, break it on down. Break it all down. It's a goofy dance, but it makes you feel like loose, because you don't want to be too tense before you go on stage. You just want to go out there feeling free. And that's what we do.
I can relate to Michelle because I remember when she joined Destiny's Child, she was the new girl on the block. And I can remember joining the Men's Dance Ministry and being the new kid on the block. And just like Michelle found her niche with Destiny's Child and got accepted by Beyonce and Kelly as her sisters, I found my niche in the Men's Dance Ministry and got accepted as one of their brothers.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
When I first started to get fans, it was definitely an honor. because I came into a group that was already established. So I was kind of nervous, like, you know what? And there might be a chance where you won't get anybody because you've already walked into some place where they've already got their fan base. And I knew that I'd get one fan at least. Hi, fan.
Now you fellas leave your girl with her friends, cause it's 11:30 and the club is jumping, jumping.
Right now as I get dressed to go to the club, the song I am singing by Destiny's Child is Sexy Daddy. You can be my sexy daddy, daddy, daddy. Rule number one of being a sexy daddy, clean sexy daddy teeth. Nobody wants to come up to you with your breath smelling like a stanky daddy. Sexy daddies are greased up. All you African Americans know what it is to be ashy and trashy. That ain't classy, not being ashy, uh-uh. Start with the elbows, gotta get those elbows. All right. Sexy daddy losing some cool points with this. You can be my sexy daddy, daddy, daddy. And that is how a sexy daddy prepares himself when he's going to the club that's jumping, jumping.
Get up and dance, get up and dance.
Dancing at the clubs releases a lot of stress for me. When I get out there on that dance floor and I'm hearing some Destiny's Child tunes, all of my problems are gone. They are just out the door. For that hour or 2 hours that I'm spinning and twirling and cutting the rug on the dance floor, I am in heaven. And I thank Destiny's Child for giving me music to get rid of my problems like that.
DC3, I love you. You have a fan like me for life. Lifelong dedicated fan right here. DC3, baby, bam!
It's really hard for us to write back on the fan letters. So a lot of times, it's way easier to just call. And if they put their number, then I'll call.
She actually said my name, which made my day.
Hi, Devin. I'm Yonsei. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I actually wrote and produced Independent Women and Jumpin' Jumpin' and 8 other songs on the last album. It's really cool when you write your own songs because people can relate to you when they see you on stage because they know that it's personal and they can see that when you're singing the songs.
So what?
This is the remix. My name is Devin, I'm 17 years old, and I'm from Calabasas, California. Calabasas is very quiet, but the people here are very nice. A lot of landscaping, and there's not too much to do. Calabasas is about half an hour away from LA. I think about 3 years ago, I first heard Destiny's Child. I was in Europe, and their video, No No No, came on. Like, hey, this group is really good, you know, I like their music. I can listen to Destiny's Child song, you know, infinite number of times.
Say my name, say my name.
Every day, I get up, go on the computer, surf the Destiny's Child websites, latest news, turn on television, MTV, VH1, watch their videos. I always have Destiny's Child blasting in my car. When I get home, it's the same thing, Destiny's Child on my computer, Destiny's Child in the background, singing. It's always Destiny's Child. I think all three of the members are really good looking, especially Beyonce, and that's another main reason that I like the group. I guess you could say she's one of the celebrities I have a crush on.
I listen to them all the time, because when I'm at Devin in the car, it's, you know, it's blasting all over. It's not hot, then when I'm blocking
your phone number, you call me over your best friend's house. Hey, I want to listen to your Survivor CD.
No, I was going to listen to that.
I think I followed in my brother's footsteps, because just basically a lot of the things that he does rubs off on me, and eventually I too turn into a Destiny's Child fan.
Music is pretty much one of my main interests and, you know, consumes a lot of my life. Wrap Up is a nationwide hip-hop and R&B magazine. I'm the editor-in-chief. The magazine idea started when I launched wrapup.com, my website. I contacted a few publishers about possibly making my idea into a magazine. Sure enough, a few days later, I got a call from publisher of H&S Media, who actually thought my idea was great and he wanted to turn it into a magazine. There's an executive editor for Wrap Up and an assistant editor. And then I had the writers from all over the US, from other magazines such as Rolling Stone, Vibe, The Source, Cosmopolitan, Entertainment Weekly. I decided what stories we're gonna do, who we're gonna interview, what albums we're gonna review, everything. We're going to the publisher's office in Hollywood. We're going there to take a look at the layout, so Wrap Up. Most of the people I communicate with online don't know my age. I'm not sure if that would scare them away or make them not want to write for the magazine, so that's why I don't tell my age, but they'll find out soon enough.
Hey, Devin.
Hi.
They're actually waiting for you in there.
Oh, they are?
Oh, Devin. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. Come on, sit down.
What do you, how do you like how we did this?
I love the way it turned out.
Devin came to us, here's at the time, a 15-year-old kid. He says, I want to do a magazine. And just his pure gumption was intriguing.
You didn't put together this magazine just for an opportunity to talk to Destiny's Child, did you?
No. You know, for the premiere issue of Wrap Up, I wanted to set up an interview with Destiny's Child for a feature story. And the marketing manager over there was very nice to me, but it took a little time and was a little trouble to first set it up.
I think the magazine's gonna do very well because I think he knows the market. He's speaking right to the same people that are gonna buy this magazine.
Dog Child 99.
Say my name. No one is around you. Say, baby, I love you.
Destiny's Child is one of my inspirations for creating Wrap Up. They're all such a young age and they've achieved a lot. Especially Beyonce, and she writes the songs herself, and she's also the lead singer of Destiny's Child. Beyonce was actually born on the same day as I was born. We have the same birthday, she's 2 years older than I am, and we also have the same goals in mind. We're both trying to achieve something at a young age. These three tapes are the tapes of Kelly, Michelle, and Beyonce talking to me in the phone interview I had with them for Wrap Up. I listen to them very often, and these are definitely the most prized possession I have. The best part of all those tapes is Beyonce saying my name without, I didn't even tell her my name and she knew my name. She's like, hi, Devin. That made the moment all worthwhile for me.
Hi, Devin.
It feels really great to see the magazine, you know, come to life and see the layout all finished and all the work that I put into it and all the writers' work they put into it actually come together with photos and captions and see it all on a paper is amazing.
Wow, it turned out so good.
I remember doing an interview with a young guy who was the editor-in-chief of a magazine, which is really cool, and it's this one is my first time seeing it.
It's amazing, almost indescribable to see my name by the article that I wrote for Destiny's Child.
The interview was a lot of fun. You would never know that you were talking to somebody 17, first of all. Like, his whole insight to everything, his questions were incredible. And look how it came out, I'm so proud.
And this is really cool.
This is definitely the coolest thing I've ever done. This cake celebrates the completion of the first issue of Wrap Up. And I'm very happy and proud that it's finally over.
Just to see it all together was really exciting. And to bring all this cohesiveness together and look that good, I'm amazed.
I'm very proud of him.
When a magazine comes out, what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna buy it.
Tell all your friends, right?
I'll tell all my friends.
All the old people. I think Destiny's Child appeals to all ages, and anyone can like them, actually. I know adults who like them a lot. Thanks.
I am sort of a fan of Destiny's Child. I like most of their songs, especially the Survivor one.
Oh,
yeah. So, but Mariah Carey, you said you like.
That was old, Nana.
Oh, that's old?
Nana, you just, I showed you.
Destiny's Child, yeah.
What's this one?
Beyonce, Kelly, Michelle.
Great.
Okay.
Great job.
We make Destiny's Child dolls from scratch, from Barbies.
And she also has her belly button pierced. Isn't that cute?
We have dolls. You don't think you're gonna have a doll. That's amazing.
It's like having your own little personal Beyonce, Kelly, and Michelle right in your house.
There are moments on stage when you definitely connect with a fan. I know the other night I connected with one. I saw this little girl that was like crying, and she was really feeling the music the other night when I was singing the story of Beauty.
I make sure that I look into their eyes and sing directly to them. And you just look at them and you just make sure they get into it, or especially when they know every single word of your song.
You know, I'm terrible with words, and I know I write the words, but I forget them all the time. And it's really cool when you can put the mic out and they just sing for you. It's like, thank you for saving me, because I really did not know what part came up next. Can you pay my bills?
Can you tell my louder. I'm a bill. Louder. Louder. I don't think you do.
So what?
So
I'm Tracy and I'm 17. I'm Stacy and I'm 17. And we're from Baltimore, Maryland. And we're twins. We've been Destiny Child fans ever since the beginning. This is Destiny. We had her for about a year, and of course she's named after Destiny's Child. Destiny's Child, they can actually sing, unlike a lot of groups that you hear out. They're very talented and they can definitely dance. Their vocals are so strong and powerful, you can just really feel all the force and the work they put in, the sounding that good. This is Michelle. Her real name is Tanitra, but we call her Michelle, just like Michelle. They brought style back to the industry. Everyone else would get out on stage with tennis shoes and jeans, but they had the complete costumes, hair, makeup, shoes, and you always see them perform in some stilettos, and I give props to anybody who can do that. With 25 hours in a day, every hour goes to Destiny's Child. That may sound obsessive, but it's really not. We have a lot of posters, a lot of pinups, a lot of articles,
a lot of magazine covers,
a lot of t-shirts.
Whatever.
We have all their CDs, all singles,
almost all their imports.
Little gadgets like dog tags,
sticks,
everything you can think of. You don't see a lot of fans with giant displays in their room. All around here is just a whole bunch of pinups, posters. This one right here is my favorite. It's an Australian magazine. This one is from the Soul Train Awards. And this one is just a giant Survivor promo poster. This one is a Carmen poster, just for the soundtrack that was in stores now.
And this is the Survivor pay-per-view concert special.
This one is an ad from Teen People. It was a contest for Destiny's Child Listening Party.
Where they found out it was the Grammy nominations, where they found out they were nominated for 5 Grammys.
And this is the new Survivor t-shirt. And this is everything else.
Whoa.
Like I say, they love Destiny's Child more than they love me. I they still give me my credit too.
We like campaign for them everywhere, helping getting people to join the Destiny's Child fan club. We go out like almost every day to buy a new magazine because there's always something they're on the cover of. So have to keep up, so I have to buy it. Okay, so far we found Black Hairstyles. We always get two copies because you need one cover for your wall and then you need One just to stay up on your display. Let's go pay for these. Hopefully get a couple people to join the fan club. You wouldn't happen to be a Destiny's Child fan, would you?
Yes.
You are? Are you in the fan club?
No.
Would you like to join it?
Sure.
You get a whole lot of cool stuff, like posters.
All right, you've referred at least 11 people. We don't actually know if they joined yet, but we did refer them.
Are you selling the new Bootylicious single by Destiny's Child?
We have it. Which one are you looking for? Are you looking for the maxi single?
Both of them.
All right, cool.
I most definitely love Bootylicious because it makes me feel like, okay, you don't have to be that perfect size 6 or size 2. You can be yourself and still be that wonderful, beautiful person you are.
Oh my God!
You can be independent. You don't have to depend on anybody but yourself. It's just empowerment for everybody.
Move your body up and down. Make your booty touch the ground.
I think the fans can relate to the topics of our songs. We're very normal people, and we go through feeling insecure about not being the typical body type. That's why we wrote Bootylicious, to make people feel good about themselves no matter how they look. We try to concentrate on having high self-esteem and just feeling powerful and being happy to be who you are.
My body too bootylicious for you, baby.
Bootylicious!
I never thought Destiny's Child would be this big. I dreamed of it, but when you're 9, I mean, it's a dream. But then that something inside of you is like, it will happen. And it did happen, but it's huge. We have dolls. You don't think you're gonna have a doll. That's amazing.
We were very young when Destiny's Child came out. So we were obviously already in the Barbies or whatever. So it started like 3 years ago. We just had an idea that we'll get dolls that kind of look like Destiny's Child. And it wasn't really to be Destiny's Child, but then as time went on, we just made them into Destiny's Child. I make the clothes and I'll get them dressed in the clothes and Tracy will do their hair, which it seems like it's an easy job, but it's not. This is Kelly. This is her red shirt and it says USA, just like her shirt. And she has the red, white, and blue belt. This is Michelle. She looks a little sloppy. She's getting her hair done. Her belt's a little loose, so let me tighten it. And this is Beyonce. Don't mind her eyes. She's suffering from blue eyes. But she has the crimpy hair and the blonde streak. So she's pretty much perfect. I wasn't even in the design and clothes and fashion and everything. And I think I'm really good at it, so they really help me recognize my talents when it comes to things like that.
Tell me how you feel about this. You try to control me, but you get dismissed.
I work hard. With the doll making, I hopefully want to like put together a resume so I can like at least like show Mattel, because I would love to work for Mattel. I always wanted to be a singer before we even knew about Destiny's Child. Just them being so successful, it made me feel like, oh, I can be that successful. And it just made me push forward with wanting to be a singer or an actress or anything I wanted to do. We will be Destiny's Child fans forever. However long they want to do it, we're going to be behind them.
I'll do it for as long as I can. Until I'm up there, independent women. I'm going to be up there singing with my girls.
When I'm like 90 years old, I'm still going to be in the nursing home. Just like, oh, my independent woman, throw them hands up at me.
We went on Star Search, we lost. We got a deal, we got dropped. So every time stuff like that happens, it's kind of like, but then that something inside of you is like, it will happen.
Someone who gets to hold you through the night.
And I thought I'd never be in a studio, especially a studio where Destiny's Child records, you know.
too many ladies out here for y'all to be that quiet.
My advice to teenagers wanting to be in the music industry, practice every day. There are so many people out there who can do what you do, but make sure that you got something different.
I just encourage them to just keep their heads on straight. If they have a dream, follow that dream. Work hard, get you a good manager like we got. And you just have to surround yourself with positive people. Let me be your bad boy, be my bad
girl, grooving to the beat, feeling the heat. Hey, what's up? My name's Bobby, I'm 21.
My name's Dave, I'm 18.
What's up, my name's Mike, I'm 18.
We are eccentric.
What?
Look me in eye and
well, eccentric's three guys that came out of Woodlands, Texas, willing to work hard and make a dream come true.
We like to be called a male pop group.
My name is Diana Liner, and I am eccentric's manager. They have a lot of fans that are slowly building in the Houston area.
Bobby and I have been performing for about 6 months together, with David probably around 3.5 months. Destiny's Child came out of Houston, and we feel like we're trying to follow the same footsteps, trying to play in Houston, get ourselves known like they did.
Friends forever.
I just look like a
friends forever.
We wouldn't be like the male version of them, in a way, you know, with our own like flavor.
But we're white.
This is my home. Follow me and I'll take you on a little DC tour. That's Destiny's Child, people. Well, I have to surround these beautiful women all around me because if you have their eyes on you, it's like they're watching out for me.
I think the biggest reason why eccentric is fans of Destiny's Child is because we've gone through a lot of stuff as a group, and seeing that somebody else went through as much as we did and more and then made it, it's like kind of gives us an inspiration, you know, something to hold on to.
Plus, so. They just have some really good music.
And
hot. They're gonna have a 3-song demo that we're putting together. We're gonna be submitted to the various record labels that have shown interest in the band.
All right, here we are at Sugar Hill Studio where Destiny's Child records, along with Eccentric, so let's give you a little tour.
There's Survivor, and then there's the Charlie's Angels soundtrack.
Hopefully, when we get done with the demo, it's definitely gonna be put right up in the case, hopefully right next to theirs. Be awesome.
Destiny's Child's harmonies are so tight, I mean, which is how our harmonies should be. I mean, ours are good, but we still need, I mean, there's still work. One of their songs that they do real, like, spectacular harmony on is Say My Name.
I know y'all know the words to this song. I want y'all to sing along. Come on.
Say my name, when you're acting, you acting kind of shady.
I'm feeling so lonely without you. Nero. Let's keep going. Let's do that one more time.
I'm gonna do it again. And just try to follow it.
Ooh, wait, ooh, wait.
I believe the Destiny Child did some of the song Survivor in there. So that's another reason why Eccentric's so excited. It's like confidence, like an aura in the air for them.
I'm feeling so lonely.
I thought I'd never be in a studio, especially a studio where Destiny's Child records, you know, and meet Matthew Knowles.
Matthew Knowles,
what's up, man? Look at this.
How you guys doing?
Hey, what's up?
Wow.
Congratulations.
Man,
this is incredible see you again, man.
Yeah,
this is awesome, man.
So what's up, guys?
Not a lot of
nothing much.
What's this?
VH1. Hey, VH1, Matthew Knowles. Hey. Can't believe this. This is about your group that you formed, yeah. Destiny's Child.
Okay, so you won.
We're the biggest fans of Destiny's Child.
Oh, I thought I was.
Okay, maybe number two.
Okay.
Eccentric went into the studio and started recording, and Matthew came and left his studio and went into the studio that Eccentric was in and came in and gave him a little advice about the music industry and about singing and things of that nature.
It's a lot of hard work. Yeah, you know, it took the ladies a lot of years. They started out at 10 years old. They never gave up. You're gonna hear a lot of people say no, a lot of times. That's why the first single was no, no, no. because you're going to hear no a lot of times. And eventually things will work out, but you can't ever quit, though. All right?
Yeah.
Hopefully when you guys reach your level of success that you will never forget to give back and to reach back and try to help someone else.
It means a lot coming from Matthew Knowles, being that he is, you know, Destiny Child's manager, and it was just kind of like a thrill and was an honor to him.
I strain to hear and every little thing.
My dad is amazing. He's the backbone behind Destiny's Child, and he's kept us humble. He tells us the stuff that most managers would be scared to tell. He tells us the truth. We still get in trouble when we're late. We still get in trouble when we're wrong. We get told when we didn't have a good performance. We get told when we have a great performance. And he's the reason why we're so grounded and strong together, like we're one.
The fact that he said that we were good even is just like a big inspiration to us, and it helps us like drive to do better, you know?
Right now we are on our way to Pasadena Square Mall, and we're gonna do our the Fun Run show out there.
Gonna do a concert. Oh yeah.
We gotta arrive in a little bit of style. I mean, to keep them in the suspense of a celebrity kind of thing going. So
yeah.
That's why Di gets the limo for us whenever we have a show. So it makes us look bigger than what we really are.
Now we just try to get ourselves real energized.
Yeah.
That's why we listen to like Survivor before the show and all that.
The song Survivor is really, really something big for them.
What?
Before the show, they play that song and they get pumped up, and that makes them run on stage and say, here we go.
As soon as you hit that first note, it's like you're running the show. You have the show. You can either sit there and look like an idiot, or you can give it your all like Destiny's Child does and just blow them away.
Let me be your bad boy, be my bad girl, grooving to the beat, feeling the heat. Meet me at the right spot, then we'll make the top drop, cruising to the beat, feeling the breeze.
Destiny Child did a lot of little mall deals. Destiny Child did festivals. It's like Eccentric's going through the same pattern that Destiny Child went through.
Like Destiny's Child, they do meet and greets before shows, after shows. You know, I've seen them like do things with fan, interact with the audience.
They're hot. They sound pretty good too. I'll be a fan forever, as long as they're around.
When she said goodbye and walked away.
I think that, you know, the Destiny's Child, you know, they don't know what they've done for us. They don't have any clue who we are even, but like, I think somewhere in like a spiritual realm, we just connect somehow, and that's where we meet.
I don't wanna hear it. I couldn't care less. It couldn't hurt more.
I have been a fan of Michael Jackson since I was a baby. But I looked to the right and he was right there. I couldn't sing. I had to start screaming. And I did, right on the stage.
Why don't you say the thing that you said to me yesterday? Come on!
No, say that I didn't do a thing.
Something's going down to the way it's strange.
Shouldn't be the reason why you act astray.
Nobody's holding you back from me.
Cause I know how you usually do.
Saying everything to me comes true.
Why can't you just tell the truth?
Somebody's there to tell me who.
Say my name.
I know y'all know.
I liked older people when I was younger. I liked Bon Jovi. Loved in love with him. I loved Prince. I loved Sheila E. Sheila E was playing the drums and she had the double bass. I was like, I'm gonna be like her, I'm gonna do this because my brother played drums and Aaron, you gotta teach me how to play the drums because I'm gonna be Sheila E. Sheila, if you watch, you give me a lesson.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well.
main lady that inspired me when I was around 5 years old was Whitney Houston. I cannot stop smiling. I love that woman so much. We've actually met her like 2 or 3 times, but every single time I meet her, each time, I'm just like in shock. She just has that diva presence, and it's not cocky at all. It's just like, I'm here, you know? I have confidence, I can do this. I love Whitney. You a G girl.
Oh my God, don't get me started on Michael. I have been a fan of Michael Jackson since I was a baby. I recently got a chance to meet him. We were doing a show for him, and he was sitting on the side of the stage. And it was time for me to sing my part. But I looked to the right, and he was right there. I couldn't sing. I had to start screaming. And I did, right on the stage. And I know the fans, because they couldn't see him. They thought I was crazy, because I was like walking up to do my part, and then I went like, just right on the stage. And I couldn't hold it. Like, I couldn't take it.
Anybody should be a Destiny's Child fan because they're so positive. They give so many people so much inspiration. It's not just the music, it's the way they live their lives are so inspirational. So anybody can take something from it. I'm
through the magazine, I'll meet different people, celebrities, and publicists and have many connections, hopefully. But always I'll know that I started with Destiny's Child, and they were the first ones that actually gave me the chance to interview them. And this is where it started, and it'll be amazing to look 10 years from now to see where I am and where Destiny's Child is at.
The biggest lesson that I've learned as a Destiny's Child fan is this. You get one chance to chase your dreams, and baby, you better get up and you better do it. If you want it, you better go get it. You better get to getting before the getting is gone. That you never think about, like the ocean, moonlight, stars, and clouds. It's amazing how we don't appreciate our blessings. There's plenty.
I visualize, like, physically seeing us, like, behind them, following them, you know, their hair blowing in the wind. You know, we're like, there's them three in front of us, and we're behind them. And then one day we can, like, branch off and be right beside them and stand in front of everybody and say, look, we came out of Houston, we made it, you know, and nobody stopped us.
Fans is what keeps you going. I mean, there's too many people that are getting so much from what you're giving that you can't stop giving. And it just makes us feel really good. We've met some really special people that are Destiny's Child fans that make us look at life differently.
When I think about a fan, I think about how Destiny's Child is possibly touching this person with their music. You have all these people supporting you, and they're so loyal. And you just sit back and you think about how blessed you are.
I would like for fans to walk away listening to Destiny's Child music inspired, empowered, and also just to have fun. We want you to be serious about life, but have fun doing it.
We love you, Ann. Good night.
I love Destiny's Child. I just love them very much. Writing on the walls, bills, 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 jump it. I just love every song they made. They are the goodest group. I like Beyonce, Michelle, Kelly. They are the bomb. I just love them. I love all their CDs. I just want to have everything in the room about them. I just want to have a whole room just about Destiny's Child. I just want to have everything about Destiny's Child because I love Destiny's Child very, very much. I just love them. They are the best.